call this meeting to order. Roll call.
Mark Clary.
Here.
Sam Zachary.
Here.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Item number three, pledge allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Item number four is recognized guest. You are signing in seats going around. We want to thank everybody for being here. Item number five is new business. Sandra, you got any new business?
I do have that we did get the judge's restroom seat. We got it completed last Thursday. So I did go up and look at that. There is a board that needs painted. I did get with Ron to take care of that. He said he would get with Neil. Other than that, that's all I've got.
Billy, got any more? Chris?
As far as business, no. I can report. I went to the city Tuesday and toured the OEM offices and their command center. I've been talking to contact Crystal Toon from the state office about trying to, what I need to do to get our office prepared to apply for some grants and stuff like that and try to bring some more money into the program here in this county. So looking into that, it's probably going to be a pretty long process, but I'm working that way.
Right.
Appreciate it.
We need all the help we need.
Yes, sir.
Do we have any updates on the hospital situations?
Well, Joe and I, everybody's been attending Sandra the every meeting we've had. Basically, where they're at right now is they're interviewing and talking to potential bidders. For the bankruptcy trustee has it in his head that, or his way of handling this is to put it out to bid. And they have what's called a stalking horse, which is all of our offerings. Let people examine it, and they'll let people have an opportunity to group our hospital in with two or three or four others. So it's kind of a flexible way of having an auction, is to say, here's the target, who wants to bid more? And then remember that because we're different than everybody else, we own our own building and we own our state operating license. Therefore, we have final say in who is selected. So if there's somebody that we don't care for and we check them out, we're not happy with them, or it's some organization that we don't want to be part of, then we can sever ourselves from them. We are not turning the doors closed on anybody. We're talking to everybody that's interested. In fact, Wednesday we'll have a meeting at City Hall with a potential company that wants to look at coming in and maybe purchasing the hospital and operating the hospital. And we're gonna explore every avenue, but we're not making a decision until it's all done. Condition of the hospital is, you got to think that she's, what, 50, 60 years old?
Yeah.
Times three, because it runs 24/7. So it's 180 years old, basically, the mechanical aspects of it. The roof is deplorable. It's a membrane roof. I've expressed and told you all what condition it was in before. Right now, I've got a contractor that is, we've come up with a plan to build up about 6 feet in concrete block off the load-bearing walls now and come in with a new truss system and put a metal roof in it and tie it all in. So it'll be like a great big addition to the top of the hospital. It won't be as tall as if there was a second story added to it, but it would shelter everything that's up there. Plus, it would eliminate having to move all the air conditioners and stuff off the roof. They'd all be able to stay in place with proper ventilation. So we're exploring that avenue. It's not cheap. The materials is already up to $190,000, just the materials. But it seems like a practical and reasonable way of doing it. Regardless of what happens at the hospital, it is our interest, the board, to keep it open constantly. We have had a couple of companies said that they'd like to shut it down and then build a new hospital instead. We're talking to them, but we're not deciding to do that. We want to keep it open all the time. So even in the interim of whether it's now or 5 years from now, we've still got to do something about that roof now. And we're figuring out now what to do with it, and then we'll try to figure out how we're going to pay for it. So that's where we're at. The trust, the bankruptcy trustee, is entertaining all offers, and they have till November today, the 4th, to have a bid in. And then they're talking about December the 19th, I believe.
19th.
It being a finalized day. And we should at that time, unless there's extensions, and there may be, we should at that time kind of find out what our destiny is going to be sometime in late December. So until then, I don't really see a great amount of change unless there's nobody bids on it. And if nobody bids, then we're going to push them to make some type of an action. But I'm pretty sure there's going to be bidders on it.
Okay.
Yeah, I might add, we don't have any money. So it's sweat equity that's going to take to repair the hospital roof. So we may ask every district commissioner to assist in some labor or dump trucks or whatever when we start making repairs. So just it's going to be a joint effort because, like I said, it's hard to do nothing without any money. And the only thing you can put in it when you don't have any money is sweat equity. So there's going to have to be a lot of sweat.
So with the new business, we'll move on to item number 6. That's approved commissioner's proceedings from previous meeting.
I've read the minutes. I make a motion to approve.
I'll second it.
Sanders, second.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Martin, second.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, I didn't see it.
Item number 7, approved blanket POs. We have one for $4,000 to Fuel Man out of the FSFP. One for $400 to Fuel Man out of STF2. One to Performance Foods for $2,500 out of the STA2. One to Panther Oil and Tire for $300 out of SSF2. Another one to Panther Oil and Tire for $200 out of the SCA2. One to Stigler Home Center for $500 out of the SCA2. One to O'Reilly's for $600 out of SSF2. That's this week's blanket.
We have one.
Yeah, we should have one in there.
Stigler
for gravel. $2,000 for gravel.
So we'll just approve it. I mean, we'll just bring that over to.
And that in.
So there'll also be one stick of stone from District 2 for what? $2,000?
Yes.
For gravel.
I make a motion on number 7.
I'll see.
Sanders, second.
Yes.
Martin, third.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Having 324A. Okay, item number 8 is to discuss and approve 324A claims for right of ways on Possum Hollow project in District 1. Looks like we have a few today. I'm going to make a motion that we approve these 324A claims.
I second it.
Martin, third.
Yes.
Sanders, second.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
amount on the blank appeals, $10,500. Where's your high sheriff today? Thank you.
today, isn't it? Okay, moving on to item nine, discuss, consider signing off quarterly monthly reports for county clerk, assessor, and health department. I'm gonna make a motion to approve these.
I'll second.
Mark McDaniel.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Sandra Lee.
Yes.
Hello, Sheriff. How y'all?
Sheriff, we got time to move back to new business for a minute if you got something.
I do. We'll be coming around to the barns the next little bit and getting you guys ID badges made. We've got ID badges made for every office in the courthouse for our employees to wear. Basically, they, if we have an active shooter or we have an emergency situation and law enforcement from another community can come over here, they'll be able to identify who our employees are. Plus, the citizens will know who they're talking to. They've got their picture on them, got their the office they work in, the office phone number. So we've got one made for everybody. I think we lack three more for the, having the courthouse done. Then we'll start moving to the barns and getting those barns done as well. So that's one thing the secretaries have been working on, getting those things done. We've been busy. We're working a three or four county burglary ring right now. It looks like we've got the lead. Looks like we're going to lead this thing up. We've got a lot of the suspects right here in our county. So I've worked on it all weekend, been out night and day, and we'll continue to be out night and day until we get them put in jail. So we're not talking just TV and stuff. We're talking about kicking folks' doors in, taking their stuff while they're gone during the day, stealing vehicles, stealing side-by-sides. I mean, they're breaking into business. Anything they can get, they can break into, they're breaking into it. And like I said, we're going to work night and day, and we're going to pay our reserves to come out and work until we can get it, until we can get it stopped. We have an idea who it is. We already had one of them in jail. We've seized many cell phones, and we're working on connecting and building the pieces through some other stuff. Jail, everything's rocking on, working well at the jail. We are waiting. Still, I've talked to Green Country. The air conditioning unit has not came in yet. They are waiting on that unit. I know Randy's mentioned it several times. It's not just a regular unit that they get. They're waiting on the dampers and different things to be put in that unit. So when they get it in, they'll be contacting us to come install it. So all we're doing is waiting on the manufacturer to get it done. I didn't realize the extent of it, but it's not just something they have sitting on the floor somewhere. It's something they have to make and get to us. So other than that, the other thing that if one of you three or if all three of you or whoever can come out and look at it, it's our side road. It's our fire lane, whatever you want to call it. It's the blacktop road. It's falling apart on us. It's sinking in. We've probably got 10 or 12 spots where it's sinking in, and it's going to give away at some point. I don't know if we need to tear it up and just build a gravel road like we've done, you know, the other part of it, just build a solid gravel road in there, or what we need to do, but it's that asphalt is giving away, and it's giving away quickly.
You have any heavy traffic on it?
The trash truck's the only thing we have.
They cause a lot of issues when they turn them,
yeah,
in the ground.
So, that's the only thing that we have is the trash truck. The food truck, we make them back up, but, you know, where the dumpster, they moved the dumpster, and where it was at, it was right in front of our kitchen door, and so we moved it back to where it went to, but the only traffic that we really have is a trash truck. And, I mean, I can't say that's what it is. I don't know. I mean, I don't know what's caused it, but I'm telling you, it's got about every 15 foot, probably 20 foot, there's big indentions in it.
For the full distance of it?
Yeah, I mean, it's like it's sinking in. And if you look at the curb, out at the curb, where we've put that rock and stuff, and it was before the rock, but the cement curb to the road's coming up too. I mean, you can see daylight 6-8 inches in that curb down that road. So I don't know I don't know what's caused these two issues, but it's issues that's happened in the last 45 to 60 days. We had one spot, and we talked about cutting it out, but in the last 30 days, the whole road's starting to tear up. So I don't know. I don't know anything about that.
A lot of wet weather in that trash truck combination, probably.
How many times did a trash truck run?
Twice a week. Sometimes you call them.
A couple times a week. So they could sure stand to run a lot more than that, but they don't.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if and usually we're one of their first pickups, so I don't know if just the trash truck in itself tear a road up like that. I don't know.
Trash truck gets a lot of static on roads, so tin horn stuff that pull off on them, pretty heavy.
So, if y'all can just look at it and let me know what we need to do with it.
Okay.
Sandra, you called me about if we had some stuff to destruct.
Yes.
We do.
Okay.
I sent Tracy a text the other day, and I didn't get back with him. We got busy. But if he can dig a hole, we've been cleaning a lot of stuff out.
Okay. Tina also has the court clerk has some stuff.
Also. I'm back on this building out here. I've got a way to get a lot of stuff done, and Jeremy French is in a different role. He's doing some investigations for us part time because he works full time at PD. Plus, he's taking care of all of our evidence. We've been with OSBI, and we know how we're going to get rid of a lot of things properly. So we're going to start working again on this building, and hopefully this winter have that building.
Talking about portable buildings. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they ain't beat out now. They're finished the courthouse.
But we're working on that diligently. We've got our evidence room fixed. We've got almost everything out of the evidence room downstairs. Almost everything's gone out of it. And then we're going to start working on that building over there. So it's taking a little time, but we're trying to get it done.
Okay, I'll get back with you.
Just let me know when. And, okay. I mean, Chris and I can get with you. And another thing, Chris and I both and Teresa went to the meeting last Thursday. Very, very informative. If y'all can get to one of them, it's very good. It's the marijuana with safety sensitive employees. A lot of safety sensitive employees that we wouldn't even think about. I mean, there's a lot of things that, I mean, you guys have a lot of weight on your shoulders on this issue. I mean, just honestly, you know, we talked about rural fire departments, we talked about everything. So it was honestly very good training, but it put a lot of perspective on county liability. And I think they're going to discuss it again next week when we go to ACCO. So they'll put a lot of perspective on it, and you know, basically told us that, you know, we're liable. I mean, for our agency, you know, I wouldn't think secretaries or dispatchers would be safety sensitive, but they are, because they take sensitive information that could result in life or death of somebody else by not getting a call out to somebody. So, I mean, just very, very good. If you guys get a chance to talk to Dale, because honestly, it was very informative and very, very good. So, that's all I got. I appreciate it.
All right. Thank you, Tim.
Okay, moving on then to item number 10, discuss and consider signing a resolution to dispose of a proof of water tank, 1974 International Haul Truck, scrap metal, and beams.
That's on that building that blew down. Everybody got the beams and stuff. That is the small, you know, the small beams that goes out of that. And everybody, we had to bid. They didn't want to put with it because it's painted up and stuff, and they really said they could build it cheaper from scratch. So we just want to make the way and put this in. You know, scratch. Yeah. And I make a motion up.
Second.
Okay.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, item number 11, discuss consider going out to bid for 2010 Renewer semi tractor truck day cab for District 3.
Again, we're trying to replace that International haul truck and with a better truck. That old truck's really not
hazardous.
Yeah, very much so. Yeah, but anyway, I'll make a motion.
Yes,
I'm
sorry.
You're fine.
Item number 12, sound appropriations, transfers of appropriations, checks received and POs.
I'll make that motion.
Yeah.
I'll second.
I get it.
Oh, that's fine.
It's all three of your girls.
Did you get two? Really?
Clark.
I made a motion.
Billy Miles, second.
Clark, third.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Sanders, second.
Yes.
I'll get you one made if you want one.
My key still goes to jail.
Should be, will be, until we, we're in the process of ordering all new key cards. The system we have, you can't put new ones on, so Ross came out and we're actually, those cards are like $7 a piece. Well, you can get the fobs that go on keychain, $2 a piece. And same one, same work, so we're gonna get those and then get our, Ross is helping us get our system up to date and get it where it needs to be. Can you come out there and look how much, look how clean it is. We're excited. Nice. The inmates want to do some painting. They've asked to paint their cells, so we're gonna let them paint their, white paint don't cost that much. But paint.
See, it's a year since we did that, but you got times three, that's open 24/7, so it catches three times the wear and tear of the normal structure.
Now, we paint our floor, but we paint the floor every week. We're painting somewhere on that floor every week, and you know, every Sunday we wax it. You never thought we'd have anything, might as well do it. So we wax the floor every Sunday, at least. But they've asked to paint their cells. Give them something new, we'll paint cells. Keep it clean.
Great. That's how you're supposed to take care of a $7.5 million facility.
You think. The only thing I wished I had regular toolbits. I wished I had toolbits that you just push the...
They'd tear them up.
Be a lot easier to fix, though.
I don't know. They're in that, what's the operator in that wall for a reason.
That's true.
Be nice if they're just more reliable.
That is correct.
It's the right design.
Just not reliable.
But here again, 24/7, around the clock, can't catch the dog around here.
So y'all need something hauling.
Like to.
See ya.
Yeah.
All right, here. Hey, you need to be for the next week.
It was hot.
seen them trash truck turf lots.
They do. I agree, they do.
The thing that said like this.
They tear up a lot of stuff.
Trust road has a top of like.
Kill the housing authority, will they instead do a construct on this? Wall it all out and had to put concrete in there.
Oh my goodness.
We have like a 6 foot from the bottom of this being down here.
Places will be have to go.
But what's.
More people drive those and stuff.
So eventually we got ready to tear all that membrane stuff out there. We pull it out.
Chris, I'm reading paper.
Two layers of plywood. Two layers of sheet.
You'd probably rather go to the same thing that come to me when they have seat. to sign off on this. I bet you can know that either.
What now?
Can't you fill these out? Somebody's gonna have to sign off on.
No, I don't think so. Good one, so she's received them.
Yeah, she received them, but usually I sign off on them after Teresa gets done. But you have to.
I don't know. I don't know.
You don't have to do that.
She just does.
I sign off on it, you know. There's some that he used to. I just.
This one. See, that's that notch up. Have this come all the way around. This building right here is actually separate from this one.
Usually they're on the back. That's how we miss them.
Oh my God, yeah. Thank you.
$5,000. We got $86,000, something last year. So it's gonna have a lot. So that could be on the.
Take a little burden off taxpayers.
Yeah. So that's good.
So all this is just like, somebody's gonna have to buy a machine.
Yeah.
Did they come by and take your pictures?
They did, but Tim just took mine off.
I had that picture taken.
No action on item number 13. Move on to item number 14, that's to adjourn.
I make a motion to adjourn.
I'll second.
Senator. Yes.
Billy Graham.
Yes.
Martin Ferry.
Yes.
I believe I missed.
Sorry about that, Billy, I'm a little hard to give you time to get through.
You did.
I was looking at that clock, thinking about that EMS.
Try and get it on.